Well, the whole trouble is your mother's.
Huh?
Well, they just don't understand men.
Then what am I doing here?
They're using the wrong approach. You've got to let your father sell themselves.
You mean so they'll think the whole thing is their idea?
Exactly.
But how?
This weekend, we get our mothers up to the lake. And we let the men stay here.
And make sure they do the wash.
Right. And Carol, you're elected to get Mr. Walligan on our side.
Mr. Walligan? Mr. Walligan, please. If you'll just make sure that you have two complete laundries ready to deliver this Saturday.
Two complete laundries?
So, this weekend you men can have that complete uninterrupted cribbage game you're always talking about. Of course, you'll have to do Mother's washing while we're away.
Oh, no, Mother. Let Daddy do the wash while we're away.
But why, Marilyn?
Well, because you need a holiday. Golly, what took you so long? Where's Carol?
Right behind me.
Good. Hey!
You girls forget anything?
We sure hope not.
May it all come out in the wash.
You make lemonade, Jim?
Must have been Marilyn. I found it in the refrigerator.
By golly, this is it, you know. Oh, wait a minute, George. I'd like to make a toast.
All you do is work out a system of pumps, and then you hook in some different valves, and then...
Well, that's not precisely what Tom Walligan told me. George, look.
Well, of course, there's a lot Mr. Warren couldn't be expected to know. But to an established company in the home laundry business, how it's made is a point of engineering concern that goes back a long way. Some 53 years, in fact. Perhaps inelegant now, these washers met the need in their day. And they set a course of valuable engineering experience. A course leading, inevitably, to today's ingenious automatic washer. Even so, how do you go about designing a new automatic washer? Well, first of all, you begin some 8 years before you decide the machine is ready for homemakers. And you begin by checking with the ultimate user herself. The first request was for an automatic washer that would get clothes as clean as standard wringer models. That meant an agitator type. How to engineer this fine idea into an automatic washer with a spin basket was a problem yet to be solved. The second request was for a method of saving suds and hot water, something the engineers themselves had long thought about. But again, figuring out how to save and reuse hot suds in a compact automatic washer with a single tub was a stiff engineering challenge. The third request was for adaptability. An automatic washer that would still let a housewife do her washing the way she wanted to do it. That meant a flexible time and cycle system. To these three basic demands, the engineers added one of their own. An automatic washer so well balanced, it wouldn't need bolting down. So armed with what would be right in an automatic washer, your lab men proceed to find out what's wrong with existing types. And then the fun begins. Most good ideas start out as problem children. It is the design engineer's job to make them adoptable. The engineer usually has a team of draftsmen to help him translate ideas into working parts. And with time and patience and trial after trial, one of your brain children at last becomes socially acceptable. you have a flexible timer. Another, the agitator, in time gets a superior twin. Again, after many tests and rejections, you finally come up with the agitator you want. One that does an even better job of washing clothes than originally requested. But here, in the suds return system, you find an engineering challenge so typical it hurts. That of developing a simple good idea into a good simple design. Starting from scratch, the first exploratory attempt was crude. The engineers tried an electric motor, an automobile pump, and a siphon line into the washer tub. The first unit was manually operated through a separate switch, and the water returned through the top opening of the washer tub. No good. In time, a two-way valve development got rid of the siphon hose, but the new pump still hung on the side of the tub, still unsatisfactory. Then both motor and pump were hidden beneath the washer, and a new problem was born. In this position, the pump now required precisely a pint of priming water to start its suds return action. A coffee can held just enough, but soon became a brightly painted, specially designed priming can.